There is a brand new book now claiming Russia was trying to hack our democratic process through a deliberate campaign long before Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump were the two nominees. But is there any evidence President Obama and his team did anything to stop it? Michael Isikoff, chief investigative correspondent at Yahoo News and co-author of a brand new book called Russian Roulette, The Inside Story of Putin's War on America and the Election of Donald Trump. Nice to see you, sir.
Good to be here.
And a good morning to you. Very interesting read. I want to start in the summer of 2016, okay? In your book, here it is on screen. One day in late August, okay? We're getting ready, 3 months from an election now.
Yeah.
National Security Advisor Susan Rice called Daniel Prieto into her office and demanded he cease and desist from working in the cyber options he was developing. Quote, don't get ahead of us, she warned him. Daniel and his team in the White House cyber response group were given strict orders. Quote, stand down, she told Daniel to knock it off, he recalled. Then you continue with a bit of salty language after that where he felt where she was coming from was not correct. Why did she give that stand down order?
Good question. A slight garble there. It was Michael Daniel, who was the White House cybersecurity coordinator, who got called in by Susan Rice and was given that directive. Daniel Prieto was his deputy, who he then told.
But both working in the cyber policy.
For the National Security Council, cybersecurity. Look, this is at a time, this is the summer of 2016. At this point, the intelligence community and the FBI has agreed the Russians hacked the DNC. They were mounting a cyber campaign against the election. They were starting to hack state election voter systems. That really alarmed people.
Even worse, though, Michael.
Yeah.
Your book shows they knew about this a year and a half before the election. Well, John Brennan was made aware of it.
Well, there was certainly intelligence that the Russians were planning major campaigns to disrupt and influence and undermine Western democracies, including the United States. We document how the United States government had a secret source inside the Kremlin in 2014 who was giving very explicit warnings.
It's even
about
worse.
This,
I mean, it doesn't make them look good.
This is, you know, much like the run-up to 9/11, the dots weren't connected. This was an intelligence failure. There was reporting about what the Russians were up to, but people didn't grasp the enormity.
Let me push forward. Daniel Prieto, as you just mentioned there on screen, the longer you wait, he warned, it diminishes your effectiveness. If you're in a street fight, you have to hit back. Right. There's not much evidence in this book that the Obama team chose to hit back
Certainly not at that point. Now, you know, they did after the election, and we can talk about that in a moment. But yes, in the summer, when there were people on the White House staff saying, in real time, if this is going to mean anything, the Russians have to see consequences. The Obama White House wrestled with this. There was concerns that if the White House went too public about what the Russians were doing, that it could actually help.
They assumed
Hillary Clinton was going to win and they could kick the can down the road. But there was also concerns that this could raise questions about the legitimacy of the election. Remember, Donald Trump is out there denying that anything's going on. The U.S. intelligence community has already reached a conclusion, Trump is sloughing it off.
So they're thinking we can't win that argument, right? But here is what I think is fine.
And by the way, Mitch McConnell in the Senate refused to go along with a letter telling state election systems, you've got to watch out for what the Russians are doing.
I was surprised that none of that was made public. Guys, jump ahead to page 193, not 194, 193, it's shorter. Yeah. It reads the following. They were concerned that were the options to leak, it would force Obama to act. Right. They didn't want to box the president in, Prieto subsequently said.
Yeah.
Why would we be afraid of a reaction to Putin or a reaction from Russia? Why would the United States government think if they put something out against Putin that he would respond in kind?
Two things. First, Obama was concerned that if he was too forceful, if he spoke out at that point in time publicly, it would look political, like he was trying to help Hillary Clinton and hurt Donald Trump. He didn't want to be perceived as political.
You could have shut down websites. You could have leaked information.
That was exactly what these people were proposing. Yes, there were real options on the table, but there was concerns from the intelligence community that this could provoke a cyber war that would escalate out of control, and that you would have, and that we, the United States, would actually be more vulnerable because we are a more wired society. James Clapper warns the Russians could shut down the electric grid, which actually is probably the most frightening aspect of this because it shows how vulnerable we are to what the Russians and what other foreign adversaries could do to us.
It's a fascinating read. Congratulations to you on writing it. I think you can find whatever you want in your book, actually, so you take that as a compliment, all right?
Okay,
Michael Isikoff with us in studio.
Thanks a lot.
More to come, okay?
Sure enough.
All right.